And that's that white-faced prick set me up. Never told him to meet me here.
Joker? He doesn't like you very much. Someone just shot him with a...
He
poison dart? Yeah. The Riddler dies already?
They broke the pact.
Who's they?
The pact.
Tell me who they are. Ah. We have to find out who this consortium is. Small-minded fools, whatever. They'll have poison darts. So he outlived their usefulness to them, and that's why they did that? Well, they were on his side to begin with. Hopefully this...
Lock the ship down! And radio for more medics!
Oh, he's loud. Hopefully I can analyze this. It leads me somewhere.
But...
Yeah, that's me.
Riddler, is he...
Yeah, that's him.
Oh, god damn it.
Yeah, he's dead. Yeah, god damn it.
Oh, this isn't good, Batman.
I know.
The investigation is a dead end without a breathing suspect. We're in trouble.
Hmm.
A lot of trouble. I have no idea how we're getting out of it.
Don't worry about it.
Don't worry about it, Jim.
How am I not gonna worry?
I don't know. Just psych yourself out of it.
Oh, Waller is gonna come down on us like a thunderbolt.
Oh, Waller.
I'm the whole goddamn hurricane.
Oh, sheesh.
I'm about to blow both your asses off the side of this ship.
I don't think you can do
that. Goddamn mess. Agent Blake is dead. Riddler is dead.
You're very observant.
And I don't know exactly how. But I know you tampered with my suspect at the casino.
I would never do
such
thing.
Unless you expect me to believe that Maury's new neck brace is a fashion statement.
Yeah, go with that. You can go with that.
Batman is clearly being misused as an asset to the GCPD.
Misused?
I'm taking direct control of law enforcement in Gotham, effective immediately.
What?
Gordon, you're being relieved of your stars.
Uh-oh.
Bumped down to deputy ops.
You can't demote me.
I just did. Don't like it? Go cry to the governor. I generously let this cowboy crap with the Batman go on out of respect.
Now wait a damn minute!
But I can see now that that was a mistake.
You're making a mistake.
Gordon's been fighting the good fight for years. You're delusional if you think you can solve all our problems.
You're the ones who are deluded.
Oh, my relationship changed.
You're so busy gazing into each other's eyes, you can't see the big picture. Take some vacation days, Gordon. I've got sensitive case details to discuss with Batman.
We're still in this together, Batman.
That's right.
This doesn't change a thing.
Absolutely. I'm not putting
this
up with her crap.
This city is about to find itself in a crisis the likes of which it's never known.
This was a long episode.
Riddler had a crew.
I like it.
Not just any crew. The worst criminal minds from all over the world, here in Gotham.
Hmm.
You come across anything about them? I'm assuming you've heard of them by now. Let me know if you have anything to share.
Riddler was betrayed.
Riddler expected his friends to back him up tonight. Guess he wasn't as popular as he thought.
Yep.
That fits a theory we have.
He's dead wrong. Get
it? Evidence from his workshop suggests he was involved in a feud with another member of the group.
Hmm. Who's this group? Now you tell me stuff.
Dr. Harlene Quinzel. Former psychiatrist at Arkham Asylum.
Like,
she's very elusive.
Harlequin?
Keeps her head down.
Get it?
Much more so than that show-off Riddler.
Harlequin.
He was going to be my way in once we captured him alive.
We got a Harlequin here.
But now I have you to lean on.
Lean on
a man
me.
Who lives on
when
both
you're
sides
not strong.
And
when
knows
I'm on
exactly
the other side of the line it. And then the cross.
Yes. You and I will be working together very closely.
I'm not ready for a relationship.
Bruce Wayne.
Don't! Oh, man. Oh, snap. She knows who we are. You and 69% of players work with Waller in a way that was strained. She was not happy when you defended Gordon. She was annoyed that you tampered with her witness. Because you went behind her back to talk to Mori, she will work with you, but begrudgingly. Gordon strained as well. So they have this relationship stuff, which is different. Can I click on that? Okay. Our relationship didn't change that much. 72% of players saw Gordon become steadfast. He appreciated you backing him up in front of Waller. He was glad that you trusted him with the truth. Because you took his side against Waller's, he is steadfastly loyal to you. And back when our relationship changed, I was afraid that, you know, our relationship changed. Let's see if I recognize any of these names. Oh, Robin Atkin Down! It's Atkin Downs, isn't it? Not Atkins. He's awesome. Robin Atkin Downs is... Well, he's done a lot of voice work, which I can't remember. If I remember, I'll put, like, stuff down here. But I know him most as the chief or the head of the telepaths in the Down Below section of Babylon 5. He's awesome. He had that long hair and that English accent. I like him. He's cool. Now I really want to remind myself of what else he's been in, because I know it. I just can't remember all this crap. 42% of players left Iman guilt-ridden. She was impressed that you stood up to Waller. She appreciated your honest answers to her questions. She is full of guilt for having survived when her friends did not. Yeah, I guess I should answer all those questions. So 72, I'm in the lead there. 69 in the lead there. Yeah. It's almost pretty much split in half, though. 50-50. 83.6% of players saw Alfred become vengeful. He was proud when you said you would bring in the Riddler in the lawful way. Showing him the video of Lucius being killed filled with him with vengeance. He approves of your decision to take the drive by force. Oh, he does. All right, that's cool. Because I like doing that thing. I don't like dealing with criminals. 88% of players left Tiffany furious. Well, at least most people did. She makes me feel a little better. She was thrilled when you told her she could help with the puzzle box. At the funeral, she was consoled when you expressed your concern for her. But because you told her the truth about endangering Lucius, she now feels betrayed. How ironic. Because we told someone the truth, they feel betrayed. 40% of players helped John to become hopeful. At the funeral, he was hurt when you dragged him away. He was frustrated with himself when you didn't like his card. Even though you didn't agree to meet his friends, he's hopeful that you'll come around. Should we really be working with him? He's the freaking Joker. We don't want him to become hopeful, right? We want to thwart his every attempt at whatever the hell he's doing, right? I don't even know. Could Joker actually be an ally in this universe? Setting, whatever. What did you tell Tiffany about Lucius's death? 88% of players told Tiffany you were involved in Lucius's death. Yeah, tell the truth. What did you tell Gordon about your connection to Lucius? 86% of players confessed to Gordon that Lucius was an ally. 8% of players told Gordon you could not talk about Lucius. 1% of players were silent when Gordon asked you about Lucius. You just sat there. 4.6% of players lied to Gordon about your connection to Lucius. So most people were, you know, truthful and, you know, all that. It's funny they don't say, obviously it's a 50-50, you know, choose one or the other, so it doesn't say the other choice there. Did you choose to visit Mori or Eli? 70% of players chose to visit Mori for information on Riddler. 30% chose to visit the other guy, the henchman, whatever his name is. Eli, yeah. It says it right there. How did you get the drive from Mori? Oh, it's pretty much split. Look at that. That's cool. I love when things are split like that. 49% of players took the drive from Mori by force. 51% dealt with him, yeah. Did you save Eman or the agents? Oh, we're in the minority here. 15% of players let the agents die by not answering Riddler's questions. I answered all but one question. I guess everyone else answered every single question. I mean, it's kind of the nature of the game to solve things, right? So you're naturally driven to try to answer the questions, right? But I figured that's not really the choice, you know, it's because it's an adventure game. You're supposed to solve things, so I think naturally you're, you know, you want to solve puzzles, right? So a lot of people will just naturally go in that direction, I think. But I figured not, because he kills the agents, we live, or he used the sound blasting thing and everyone dies. So... yep. That stuff. So we're dumped here. We're talking to the server. So now, yeah, I did turn the cloud saving on. I guess it worked after a while, but... I know in Batman, the first one, the cloud saves were screwing everything up, but then I guess I turned them back on, because when I went back into the game, the first game I'm talking about, they were there. So, I mean, it was on. So if we go extras, what if we go turn to the Batcave? Oh, it's literally just this. So we're back in the Batcave from here. I want Catwoman to return. She was awesome. I can actually look around more. We're going down. Oh, really? Can I... okay. Whoops. Whoops. I'm drunk, I'm sorry. Look at the bat suit. This is cool. Huh. Bat suit, early prototype. My suit always takes a lot of damage, but still does what it's supposed to do. Hide my identity, intimidate criminals, and keep me alive. This is an older model of Lucius Fox's design. I had to revert to it after my bat suit was damaged in a fight with Lady Arkham. It's not as advanced, but that's good. I never want to be too reliant on technology. Anchor. Heavy grappling device. I can't be everywhere at once, but this design makes it easy to take care of business from across a room, whether that business is wresting weapons away from criminals or stopping something heavy from falling on bystanders. Stunner. Administers instant electric bolt. Yeah, I like that thing. This device can stop a criminal cold with a powerful electric shock. It's flashy and unsubtle, but it's guaranteed to incapacitate a target no matter their size. Smoke grenades. Projectiles emitting non-lethal smoke. They look like a 10-sided die. Or maybe 8-sided die. These grenades create a smoke screen that confuses enemies and allows me to hide, striking from the shadows. Batarangs. He doesn't call them batarangs. I don't think I've ever heard the word batarangs heard in these games. Military-grade titanium weapon. A few of these can clear out a room full of gunmen. Heavy, sleek, and extremely sharp. Chop their heads right off, baby. Grapple gun. Fires long-range grappling hook. This gun allows me essential freedom of movement around the city, whether that's from building to building or straight up from a crowd of enemies. Previous model. Wait. Oh, the early prototype, I read that one. Not the previous model. Didn't think so. My suit always takes a lot of damage, but it still does what it's supposed to do. Hide my identity, intimidate criminals, and keep me alive. This batsuit was damaged in fights against the Children of Arkham and Harvey Dent's paramilitary troops. Lucius has since given me an even better version of the suit. I hold onto this one to remind me to never let my guard down in battle. We were heading this way, I guess, then. I guess we've seen it all. Yeah. Does he say anything about these if I look at him? Guess not. There's the other bat suit. What else we got? Where's that everything around here? I think I was clicking on that. Yeah. Alright, back down. It's so quiet. So if I go this way, hold on. Oh my. Batmobile.
Oh, that's the stuff.
That's cool.
That's still the stuff.
Still the stuff. Love it.
Every single time.
Love it. So a lot of people are going to miss this, right? Because you have to go into from the main menu back to the Batcave.
Like sweet music.
How many times can we pull the string here?
Never gets old.
Guess not.
Never gets old.
Again?
Okay, I should stop. Don't want to lose its luster.
No, one more time. Oh, I can't select it. Oh, damn it. Can I walk all around it? No. I can go up those stairs though there. Must be nice having a waterfall right under your own house. I mean, technically not a waterfall, no, but still. You mean I can't go up these stairs? What am I, handicapped all of a sudden? Thank you. Stuck there for a second. Now I do want to see if they updated codecs and stuff. Because what's his name? The agent is dead. What is this? Can't use that. I don't suppose these have changed. Nope. Is this for future enemies on the other side? The wall there? Together with this, this is the longest Telltale episode for a long time. Let's see, any new articles? Seeing that, right? We go down, look at this. The stock. Dent trial. This is all the same. What is the agency? Cobblepot. Wish I could scroll faster. This is new. Family describes Slain Wayne. Seriously? Employee as hero by Kate Clark. Friends, family, and even billionaire Bruce Wayne gathered at Gotham's Divinity Church today to pay their respects to Lucius Fox, the Wayne Enterprises' chief technology officer killed in the explosion that rocked Wayne Tower last Tuesday. An emotional Tiffany Fox, the executive's daughter, described her father as my hero. So is she still working at Wayne? I guess so. Fox had been a longtime employee of Wayne Enterprises, shepherding the company's cutting-edge technology through research and development onto the market. Many have credited him as the true genius behind the Wayne Company's enormous success. Though Bruce Wayne himself declined to speak to the press at the funeral, in a statement he called Fox irreplaceable and my most trusted advisor. That is true. So, I guess she's just started working there and she's getting a bereavement leave. I don't know, problem given to her. Following the funeral, Fox was laid to rest in a family plot at Gotham Cemetery. Opinion: I was wrong about Batman, by Max Maloney. In what way? It's not so often I admit defeat, so print this one and hang it on your refrigerator. Right. Today's a banner day, and it won't come around anytime soon. That's right. I'm telling you I was wrong. About what, you ask? Batman, of course. Mind you, I'm not looking to invite the guy over for dinner anytime soon, but ever since I first heard the word Batman, I've been warning everyone who would listen that at best he's a lunatic, and at worst he's a grave danger to our city. Which brings us to now. Last night I took my dog for a walk after work, in the dark near Cobblepot Park. That's a bad idea. That was your first mistake. Actually, your second mistake, I guess. Thinking Batman is a lunatic and a grave danger to the city was the first mistake. And guess what? The dog and I made it out alive. The thought of being mugged didn't even cross my mind. You're an idiot. Which made me realize just how safe our streets have become the past few weeks. And it made me think, maybe this Batman guy, who's been helping out the cops, isn't such a bad guy after all. Sure, I'd love to know why he's doing what he's doing, but maybe that's just the old reporter in me. For now, I think I'm happy just knowing things are getting better. Bizarre Riddler launches terrorist attack at Gotham Casino, by Kate Clark. Kate Clark's been busy. Gotham police were on the lookout for a masked criminal known as the Riddler, after he led a brazen terrorist attack at the Virago last night. That attack was stopped by Batman with the assistance of the GCPD, further proof of their successful partnership. The focus of the attack was reportedly Gotham businessman Rumi Mori, who is currently hospitalized in what officials say is a serious but stable condition. The Riddler evaded capture and remains at large. However, GCPD Commissioner James Gordon said all available resources will be assigned to his immediate capture. However, Gordon would not comment on reports that operatives from the agency were on the scene almost immediately. Investigation into Wayne Tower explosion continues, by Connor Barton. Authorities are still searching for the cause of a massive explosion that ripped through the high-rise headquarters of Wayne Enterprises in downtown Gotham last Tuesday. According to multiple reports, the agency, a highly secretive governmental crime-fighting organization, has also joined the investigation. The explosion, which killed Wayne Chief Technology Officer Lucius Fox and injured 14 others, is still being called an industrial accident. The involvement of the agency in this investigation raises many questions about the nature of the explosion, but both GCPD and Wayne Enterprises aren't making further comments at this time. Codex? We've got almost everything updated. So this we drag. Okay, so the new stuff is at top, so I'll just read what's above the dashes here. I figured it would be underneath, but... Gordon promised that what happened at the harbor won't change anything between us. I'm not so sure. Waller pinned the blame for the Riddler's death and the abduction of her agents on Gordon. She used it as an excuse to strip him of his position as police commissioner. Now she's taken over the GCPD. I can't help but wonder if I could have stopped it. Gordon trusts me, but I couldn't save his position. I won't forget that. Montoya didn't appreciate me going behind Gordon's back to talk with Eli Nabel, but with lives at stake... I didn't talk to him. What? But with lives at stake, I couldn't worry about what she or Gordon thought. I had to act. I left Eli bleeding all over the precinct floor, something Montoya won't soon forget. It took a long time to build trust between her and Batman. Now it's gone. Sometimes that's the cost of getting answers. Okay, this should not be here. I did not talk to Nabel. What the hell? Deceased. Lucius is gone. He died in an explosion at Wayne Tower, helping me solve Riddler's puzzle. Loyal friend to the end, his last words will always haunt me. That psycho Riddler was responsible for his death, and I will stop at nothing to avenge him. Yeah, it did that. This is no... Oh, there is dashes. Wait. I wish I could drag with the mouse like the other mouse wheel. See, because it sticks. Anyway. I never thought I'd see John's face again until he showed up at Lucius's funeral. Evidently, he listed me as his emergency contact when he was discharged from Arkham. Could he be stalking me? I say definitely. He wanted me to meet his new friends. I said no. I really don't want to make him think this friendship is going anywhere. Something good did come out of our conversation. John gave me a solid lead on Riddler's location that pointed me to an abandoned water tower in Gotham's East End. Could John Doe and Riddler really be connected? And if so, how? I don't remember reading this. Was he even in the files? My time in Arkham was short, but one patient in particular left an impression on me. I didn't catch his name, but I won't ever forget his face or his laugh. He's like some kind of creepy circus clown. I don't remember reading that. Okay, there doesn't seem to be anything new here. Okay. We get up to the agency. Tiffany Fox. Lucius's funeral didn't go well. Tiffany naturally had questions about her father's death, especially specifically if Riddler's contraption had anything to do with it. So I told her the truth. I owed her an honest explanation. Right. But in this case, honesty was not the best policy. She blew up at me, threatening to dig deeper into what Lucius and I were doing. Maybe I should get in front of that. Get in front of that? Like in front stopping her, or get, like, help her? I don't know. Iman Avesta. Agent Avesta and her team attempted to corner the Riddler at the docks, but ended up caught in one of his traps. She begged me to save her colleagues by playing along with the Riddler's game. Despite her trust in me, Agent Blake died because of my words. I'm not sure if she'll ever be able to forgive herself or me for what happened. You do. Amanda Waller. Yay. Not liking her very much right now. I was happy to see her at the beginning when she came in, but yeah, she's a lot of trouble. Waller blamed Gordon for the Riddler's death and the capture of her agents. Fair or not, she's taken over the GCPD, stripping Gordon of his title as police commissioner. I don't trust her, and she certainly doesn't trust me, but I have to work with her now, however I feel about it. Waller knows my identity, and she could go public with it any time. I need to tread carefully around her. Yeah, how the hell did she find out? Agent Vernon Blake, the agency, deceased. The Riddler ambushed agents Blake and Avesta at the docks, using them as bait for me in one of his sick games. Agent Blake pleaded for me to lose so that Agent Avesta's life would be spared. I failed the Riddler's game, and Agent Blake paid the price. His sacrifice saved his partner's life just as he had wanted. Yeah. Eli remains in police custody and refuses to give up any information about the Riddler, his plans, or his allies. It's unclear if Eli stays silent out of loyalty or fear. Whatever, I didn't talk to the guy. The Riddler ambushed Agent Avesta and her team at the docks in an elaborate trap. He forced me into playing one of his games in exchange for their lives. In the end, I managed to outsmart him, but at a heavy cost. Before we could bring him in for questioning, Riddler was mysteriously killed with a poisoned dart to the neck. All I have now are his cryptic last words. They broke the pact. But who are they, and why did they want him dead? Yeah, I'm surprised. He was, like, the big villain for this season. And, hey, he's dead already. We have 4 more episodes to go. 4 more chapters, whatever. Rumi Mori. I decided to pay Mori a visit at his casino, where he was being kept under the watchful eye of the agency. He admitted to selling Riddler the missiles that he had been using to target his enemies. In exchange for giving up Riddler's location, Mori demanded I pay for his escape out of the country. I refused to help Mori escape justice and took the intel on Riddler by force. I may have made an enemy of him, but he won't be up to hitting back anytime soon. That's good. The agency. The agency has fallen squarely into the Riddler's crosshairs. He blames them for creating him, though he refused to elaborate on what that means. Yeah, I'm interested to find out the truth behind that. Well, the whole story, whatever. Somehow he managed to learn the identities of all of Waller's agents and compile them into a hit list. It seems even the most secretive organization is not out of this madman's reach. Okay, nothing new about Thomas Wayne, of course. Anybody else? Updated. Here we've got this one. Gotham City. A new class of criminals has converged on Gotham. According to Waller, they're the best of their kind and the most dangerous. John Doe, the Riddler, Dr. Quinzel. How many of them are there? Harley Quinn. Riddler's plans to terrorize the city ended with his death, but his friends are far from finished. I'll need to deal with this new threat to Gotham, and soon. Well, I'm guessing the John Doe, quote-unquote, friend, one of them must be Harley Quinn. Because they're always, hang out together. It was a homing missile that caused the explosion at Wayne Tower. I should have never brought Riddler's puzzle into my office. I put my employees at risk. We might be able to rebuild the tower, but we'll never be able to fill the hole left in ranks by Lucius's loss. Riddler's hideout, abandoned water tower, Gotham's east end. Oh, it starts... Oh, there's only one entry here. Gordon and I found out where Riddler sleeps. He's set up a hideout in an old water tower on the edge of Gotham's east end. Walking around that place was like taking a tour of Riddler's twisted psychology. He's methodical and obsessive in his sadism, using agents as guinea pigs to test out his prototypes of his murder boxes. I call them murder boxes. Death chambers, I think. Designed to be a giant escape room, Gordon and I almost didn't get out of there alive. Luckily, Gordon was instrumental in solving his riddle, and we managed to escape together. I guess two heads really are better than one. Is there more? No. And finally, Gotham City Police Department HQ. Waller used her political clout to take over the GCPD. It's unclear how she'll use her power, but from what I've seen, she won't let police procedure get in her way. Yeah. Here's a pain in the butt. Okay, I guess we're done here. Yeah, well, I can't save. This is just a look around the... Yeah. So, guys, thanks so much for watching. Whenever the next episode, next chapter comes out, you know it'll be up here on the channel. See you next time, guys, and always, seek adventure.